Welcome to Gurudev online class. My dear students, in the last class we were discussing about the poem written by Mary Doe Bryan, where she explains that there was an old woman or a lady who was aged, who was wearing a torn clothes, and her color was gray, and she was expecting someone to help her because actually she wanted to cross the road, but in the crowd there was no one to read her anxious eyes. In the entire crowd where she was standing, in the middle of the crowd, none of the people offered her helping hand. Everybody were seeing her and they were just passing her by. And later, after some time, one of the school children, when the school bell rang, they came to the street with shouting and laughing, because just they finished the school and they were greeting, they were welcoming the snow and they were playing with the snow. Even those children, they too didn't help the old lady to cross the road. Okay, next, what happened? That lady, she was very humble, she was very afraid to move because the street was wet because of the recent snow, and she was fearing that if she is going to walk there, her leg may be slipped and she may met with a horrible incident. So till here we discussed, and now we will discuss what happened later, who helped her to cross the road. Okay, lest the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should crowd her down in the slippery street. At last came one of the merry troop, the gayest laddie of all the group. He paused beside her and whispered low, "I will help you across if you wish to go." Her aged hand on his strong young arm she placed, and so without hurt or harm, he guided the trembling feet along, proud that his own were firm and strong. Then back again to his friends he went, his youngest heart happy and well content. She's somebody's mother, boys, you know, for all she's aged and poor and slow. And I hope some fellow will lend a hand to help my mother, you understand. If ever she's poor and grey, whenever her own dear boy is far away. And somebody's mother bowed low her head in her home that night, and the prayer she said was, "Good God, be kind to the noble boy who is somebody's son and pride and joy." Okay, when the boys came out from the school playing with the snow, even they too didn't offer a helping hand to the lady, and they too didn't help the lady to cross the road. Later, lest the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should crowd her down in the slippery street. As I already told, as we already discussed in the previous class, the street was slippery, means the street, the road was slip. It was slipping. Because of what? Because of the recent snow. Because of the recent snow, the street became completely slippery. Lest the carriage wheels, what is the meaning of lest? In case. Or there is a possibility, in case, maybe. There is a possibility, in case, or lest the carriage wheels or the horse's feet. What is the meaning of carriage wheels here? Horse cart. Just like a bullock cart, horse cart. Okay. In case the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should crowd her down in the slippery street. Means in the street, when we are talking about or when we are discussing about the street, it is quite common that the street, the road will be filled with the number of vehicles. So that lady who was old and she was poor and she was very slow, and in case in the slippery street, if she is going to walk, what happens? She is not that fast to cross the road. She has to go very slow and in the road, on the road, there are number of vehicles will come. So what may happen? Some of the what horses, cart or some of the carriage wheels, she may crowd. Should crowd her down. Crowd means what is the meaning of crowd? Push. If she is not going to walk very fast on the street, someone may crowd her, someone may push her, and she may get into an accident with the horse cart, or the horse can step its feet on that lady. Okay. Least the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should crowd her down in the slippery street. At last came one of the merry troop, the gayest lady of all the troop. While she was thinking all these things, she was thinking, if I go on that street, which is already wet, which is already slippery, if I go, someone may push me, someone may crowd me, and I may get into the horse feet, or I may get hit by the horse cart or carriage wheels. So while she was thinking like this, what happened? At last came one of the merry crew. Finally, or at last came one of the merry crew. What is the meaning of merry crew? Merry crew means quick and energetic. Merry crew means quick and energetic. Or you can also call it as a group of soldiers. You can also call it as what? Merry group means quick and energetic, or you can also call it is a group of soldiers. Okay, army men. At last came one of the merry troop, the gayest lady of all the group. In that merry troop, in the group of soldiers, there was a gayest lady. What is the meaning of gayest lady? A happy boy, a cheerful boy, a joyful boy. So in that merry group, one of the gayest lady of all the group, there was a boy who was very happy, who was very joyful, who was very cheerful. Where? In the merry troop, or in the group of the soldiers. He paused beside her and whispered low. Who paused beside her and whispered low? Yes, the gayest lady, or the happiest boy, or the cheerful boy. He paused beside her. What is the meaning of paused here? Paused means waited. He waited near the lady. What happened here? He, the gayest lady, the one of the boy of the merry troop, he waited beside her. Her means here the old woman who was crossing the, or who need to cross the road. He paused beside her and whispered low. What is the meaning of whisper? Speak in a low voice. Whispered means speak in a low voice. He paused beside her, or he waited beside her, and he talked very slowly. What he said? I will help you cross if you wish to go. He said, by looking at the woman, that boy came to know, yes, that woman wants to cross the road. And he went, he stood in front of that woman and he said, I will help you. I will help you to cross the road if you want to. If you don't bother, or if you don't mind to take help from me, I will help you. I may help you to cross the road. I will help you across if you wish to go. Her aged hand on his strong young arm, she placed, and so without her hurt or harm. Her aged hand on his strong young arm. Here, her aged hand. Here there is a boy and there is a lady. The boy is very young, whereas the lady is very old one. So what she did? She kept her old hand. She kept her old hand on the strongest young arm. Here young means the age. The age of the boy. He is very young, whereas the woman is very old. Right? So she kept her hand, or she holded the hand, youngest hand on of that boy. Her aged hand on his strong young arm, she placed, and so without hurt or harm. What the boy did? By holding the old hand,
by holding the aged hand without hurting or harming the lady, he took that lady.
Okay. He guided the trembling feet along, proud that his own were firm and strong. That boy guided. What is the meaning of guided here? Here guided means helped. Guided means what is the meaning of guided here? Help. He helped the trembling feet. What is the meaning of trembling? Shivering or shaky. Shivering or shaky. Why that woman was trembling? Why she was fearing? Why she was shaking? Why her entire body was just like a shaky one? Yes, because she was old, she was aged, and along with that, she was bent with, not only because of the age, but also because of the chilly cold. Because of the chilly wind or the cold temperature of the winter's day. So, he, the boy, helped the trembling feet. Means, here, the boy helped the woman. Here, trembling feet is nothing but, the boy helped the woman, proud that his own were firm and strong. While he was helping the old woman, he came to know that old woman's hands are very aged one. So now he is very proud. He is very proud. For what reason he is very proud? For what reason the boy is very proud of himself? Because but he is comparing that woman to whom actually he is helping. She is an aged one. But here her arms become very weak. Whereas he is boasted. He is having proud of himself because his own arm are firm and solid. What is the meaning of firm? Firm means solid. What is the meaning of firm? Solid and strong. The boy is feeling proud by seeing the appearance, by seeing the health, by seeing the strength of the lady. Here, the lady's arms became very weak, whereas the youngest boy's arms are very firm and strong. So for that reason, that boy is feeling very proud of himself. Then back again to his friends he went, his young heart happy and well content. Finally, he helped the woman to cross the road, and then back again to his friends he went. Again, after helping, after giving the helping hand, after helping the woman to cross the road, again he went to his fellow men, he went to his friends. Then back again to his friends he went, his young heart happy and well content. After going back to his friends, his young heart happy and well content. What is the meaning of well content here? Well content means satisfied. For what reason his heart is happy and he is feeling satisfied? Yes, imagine, or you might have already, you have experienced this. When someone need your help, when you offer them a help, how you will feel? You will feel very happy, right? Imagine a dog. It is the puppy of the dog. It is feeling very hungry. So what you will do? You have 2 rupees. You go to a bakery. You take a small piece of a bun or bread. You will give to that. You will feed to that puppy. How you will feel? Whether you will feel very sad. I have used my 2 rupees. No, you will feel very happy, right? Not only that, if a old woman is going and she is asking help, she is asking, begging you, you have 1 rupees or 2 rupees, when you give to that lady or that woman, she will become happy, right? So what it made you? If you give your 2 rupees to that lady, whether you will become sad or just give my 2 rupees to that lady? No, you will become happy, right? It means when we are going to help someone, when we are going to offer a helping hand, from inner self, we will become very happy. Is it or not? We ourselves become very satisfied. So for the same reason, when the old woman, actually she was desperate to get a help to cross the road, none of the person helped her, but one of the gayest laddie or one of the happiest boy helped her, and because of that helping, her heart, young heart, was happy and he was very well content. He was satisfied.
means he thought, yes, that day I did a good thing. At least I helped a woman to cross the road. She is somebody's mother. Boys, you know, for all she is aged and poor and slow. He told to the boys, she is somebody's mother. Am I right? Right? Yes. When he went to that boy, back to his friends, he told to his friends that, my dear friends, he might be somebody's mother. He might be, or she is a somebody's mother. She is not my mother. I helped her not because she is my mother or she is my relative or she is my friend or whether I have any relationship. No. She might be somebody's mother. He told, she is somebody's mother, boys, you know, for all she is aged and poor and slow. She is somebody's mother who is very poor. Poor means not financially, health-wise. She is very poor. She is sick. She is fearing. She is trembling. She is very slow and she is very aged. That old woman, she might be somebody's mother who is very poor, who is very aged and who is very slow. And I hope some fellow will lend a hand to my helping, sorry. And I hope some fellow will lend a hand to help my mother, you understand. And he told to his friends, and I hope some fellow, fellow means what is the meaning of fellow? Fellow means boy or men. And I hope some fellow will lend a hand to help my mother, you understand. He is telling, I helped somebody's mother. I helped a woman whom I don't know. But in case my mother will be in that situation, someone else will help her. Is it or not? This is the revolution of the earth, my dear students. Whatever you do, it comes back to you, right? If you throw a stone upside, whether it will go up, it will come down. Every action has its equal and opposite reaction, right? So, if you help someone, one day, someone may help you, right? So, this is what you call karma. It is a revolution. Revolution of life. If you help someone, one day, someone will help you. Am I right? Yes, so he told. And I hope some fellow will lend a hand to my helping, to help my mother. You understand me? Today, I have helped someone's mother. So, in case, sometimes, or in any day, if my mother need a help, someone may help her. And I hope some fellow will lend a hand to help my mother, you understand. If ever she is poor and grey when her own dear boy is far away, means if my mother will be in the same situation, when my mother will become old, when my mother will become aged and slow, if she met with the same incident or if she is in the same situation, someone will help her. Like I did. Like I helped the old woman whom I don't know, someone may help her if she is ever poor and gay. Means if my mother, who will become old, slow and gray, when I am not there to help her, when I am far away to help her, because I already told, married troop means a group of soldiers. Soldiers means they have to go from one place to another place and for months, years, they won't return to the home. So, in that situation, if any time, if my mother needed a help, someone may help her when I am very far away. When I am very far away from my mother, if my mother will be in the same situation, in the same circumstances, someone may help her just like I helped the old woman. And somebody's mother bowed low her head in her home that night and prayer, she said. And that lady, that old woman who got help by that gazed lady on that night, She bowed her head. Bowed means bowed. What is the meaning of bowed? Bent. She bent her head and she whispered or she prayed to the God. We are having a habit, right? Before going to the bed, we will thank God for making our day beautiful, for making our day wonderful. Okay. And somebody's mother bowed low her head in her home that night and prayer. She bowed her head that night and she was thanking to the God and she was praying. And in that prayer, she said, God, be kind to the noble boy. In the prayer, what the lady told on that night, after taking help from the boy, what the lady prayed, she said, God, be kind. Means, oh God, show your mercy. Always keep your blessings. Always help the boy. Which kind of a boy? Noble boy. What is the meaning of noble boy? Having a good qualities. Means showing mercy to someone, offering a helping hand. It is a kind of a quality, right? It is a kind of a good quality, right? Like just like the honesty, being truthful, respecting someone, obeying the words of our elders. Like these are the good qualities. In that one, showing merciness, showing sympathy, showing empathy towards someone is a kind of a good quality. So the woman is telling, oh God, my dear God, please be humble. Keep your blessings on the noble boy who is somebody's son, pride and joy. She is telling, oh God, oh my dear God, I am thankful that boy, one of the noble boy, who came and who helped me to cross the road. Please keep your blessings. Please keep your blessing. Please keep your hand on the noble boy who is somebody's son, pride and joy. What is the meaning of pride? Pride means proud. Who is somebody's pride and joy? Here, what does it mean? Who is somebody's son and pride and joy means? For everyone, their children are their happiness and proud. Because of them, because of the children, the parents are very proud. So the lady is telling, oh God, please always keep your blessings on the boy, noble boy, who is somebody's son, who is somebody's proud, and who is somebody's what? Joy. So by saying this, we'll conclude the lesson. My dear students, by this poem, we'll come to know that we have to always show love and affections towards the people. Only the blood relations are not the relation. Helping someone, if someone is asking the help to you, you should not think whether I know that person, whether if I help her, him or her, what will be the consequences. You should not ever think like that. If someone is asking help, forget everything and you should always have a helping hand towards others. Whenever you see someone is need your help and if you think you can help them to some extent, you go and help them. So this poem shows or depicts that you have to have a concern, love and affections towards everyone. Okay, my dear students, thank you.